As we saw in our last two videos, musical meter arises from the various levels of pulse we feel when we listen to or play music. We focused on three levels in particular. We have the beat, which is the pulse that we tap along to. We have the measure, which are groups of beats, two, three, or four of them. And then we have the beat division, which is whether the beat divides into two straight or swung divisions or three compound divisions. It's important to remember that these pulse levels are felt, not given to us by the composer or anyone else. And different people can feel these pulse levels differently. What I feel as the beat, you might feel as the beat division, and even the same person can feel the beat and the beat division and the measure differently throughout the song, even if the pulses kind of don't change. So in this video, we'll talk about what we do when we try to write down musical meter. So how do we write meter? We use what's called a time signature. A time signature has two numbers on top of one another. The top number tells you how many beats are in a measure, and the bottom number tells you what notated value corresponds to a beat. For example, in the time signature 4-4, the 4 on top tells you there are 4 beats in a measure, and the 4 on the bottom tells you that a quarter note represents 1 beat. Likewise, in the time signature 2-8, there are 2 beats per measure, and the 8th note represents 1 beat. The notated value of the beat is not anything we hear, it's just a notational matter. Anything in 4-4 could also be written in 4-8 or 4-16 or 4-256. You would definitely get fired if you wrote in any of those, but it could be done. So once we have a time signature, we can write notes, and we know how many beats those notes represent. So here's a simple rhythm in 4-4 time. These vertical lines here are called bar lines, and they separate each measure from the next. So this notation shows where each level of pulse occurs. The measure level pulse follows the bar lines, and the beat level follows the quarter notes. In the second measure, we hear the straight beat division with those 2 eighth notes. And the pulse levels continue even when not every beat has a new note on it. Here's another rhythm, now with a 2-8 time signature. Here there are 2 beats per measure, but it's the eighth note, not the quarter note, that represents 1 beat. So in the third and fourth measures, those quarter notes last 2 beats each, or 1 full measure. Time signatures with 2, 3, or 4 as the top number can only have 2 beat divisions, not 3. That's because notated rhythmic values are inherently binary. If a quarter note is a beat, then eighth notes are the beat division, and there are 2 eighth notes in a quarter note. Eighth notes divide into 2 sixteenth notes, and so on. So these time signatures can have straight or swung divisions. If we don't write anything else, we assume straight divisions. To indicate that divisions should be swung, we can write this little thing here that says 2 eighth notes equal a quarter note plus eighth triplet. That just means that when you see eighth notes, the first one is about twice as long as the other. Sometimes, especially in jazz scores where swung divisions are common, you'll just see the word swing. So what about those compound divisions? Time signatures with compound divisions, which as you remember is 3 equal divisions per beat, have 6, 9, or 12 as the top number. Why? To have beats divide into 3 equal divisions, you need to use a dotted note value as the beat. For example, a dotted quarter note divides into 3 eighth notes. So if we want compound duple meter, we need a time signature that shows that there are 2 dotted quarter notes per measure. Unfortunately, there isn't a way to indicate a dotted quarter note with the denominator of a fraction. We can't really put a 2-3 time signature. That doesn't make any sense. So we need instead to use the beat division as the basis for the time signature. In this case, that's the eighth note. So if there are 2 dotted quarter notes per measure, then there are 6 eighth notes per measure. So our time signature becomes 6-8. Important. This does not mean there are 6 beats per measure. There are 2, not 6. We always have to divide by 3 to get the number of beats in a measure when we have compound divisions. So 6/8 has 2 beats per measure, and the dotted quarter note represents the beat. The eighth note is the beat division, and there are 6 eighth notes per measure, 3 eighth notes per beat. 9/4 has 3 beats per measure, 9 divided by 3, not 9 beats per measure, and the dotted half note represents the beat. 12/16 has 4 beats per measure, and the dotted eighth note is the beat. So, to summarize, time signatures with 2, 3, or 4 on top have that many beats per measure, 2, 3, or 4. And the bottom number tells you the note value of the beat. If the bottom number is 4, you have a quarter note beat, 8 is an eighth note beat, 2 is a half note beat, etc. Time signatures with 6, 9, or 12 on top have 1/3 that many beats per measure. So 6 means duple meter, 9 means triple meter, 12 means quadruple meter. And the bottom number of the time signature tells you the beat division value. So to get the beat value, you have to go up one note value and dot it. So if you see 8 on the bottom, you go up one note value from eighth note to quarter note and then dot it. So 8 means a dotted quarter note beat. 4 means a dotted half note beat, and 16 means a dotted eighth note beat. Here's a table of the time signatures you're most likely to encounter in written music. Not all of these are equally common. The most common signatures you're going to see are 4/4, 6/8, 2/2, and 3/4. Note that 4/4 is also sometimes written as just a big C, which stands for common time. 2/2 can likewise be abbreviated as C with a line through it, which stands for cut time.